local breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
The images just keep coming. New views of what tornadoes did to Oklahoma and the heart of America yesterday. The stories of survival include heroes.
I don't know what that lady's name is, but she had three little kids underneath her. Good job, Teach.
And rescuers, the search for loved ones and survivors. More on the Oklahoma tornadoes in a moment, but first, some weather going on here at home.
Chief Meteorologist John Sesswich is on it. John, some storms on your radar right now, right?
Yeah, we have several warnings, Michael and Carol, severe thunderstorm warnings, and these are going to continue for a little while. One here, obviously, just east of downtown Asheville in the east central part of Buncombe County. Also, severe thunderstorm warnings continue for you folks in central and southern part of Pickens County, northwestern Oconee County, and back into northeastern Rabun County, almost in the same place that we had yesterday. Besides potential for large hail and maybe winds over 60 miles per hour with some of these thunderstorms. Notice how electrical. This is for the second day in a row. Extremely electrical thunderstorms getting about 400 or 500 hits per hour from these clusters of thunderstorms. This is actually what we call an outflow boundary. These thunderstorms collapsed in Newberry County, producing some wind damage around you folks in Prosperity. And as the thunderstorms collapse, all the winds come down from the thunderstorm and then fans out. And it acts like a little mini cold front. This little sliver here shows you how sensitive live Super Doppler 4 HD is. This is like a little mini cold front. Sometimes thunderstorms can develop along this front as it moves into Greenville County. We'll be watching that closely. And we'll talk more about that same storm system responsible for the EF5 tornado that occurred in Moore, Oklahoma yesterday. That storm system is still spawning tornadoes and producing severe weather out to the west. We'll talk about that in detail a little bit later on. Now back to you, Carol.
Thanks, John. And the National Weather Service says it is seeing signs that yesterday's Oklahoma tornado could have been an EF5. It killed dozens of people, including 9 children.
Their elementary school took a direct hit yesterday. Everyone inside the building ended up buried in debris. The tornado, as you may know by now, hit the community of Moore, Oklahoma, and an EF5 is as bad as they get. We're told the winds reached up to 200 miles per hour. Look at this thing. So strong, the walls of Plaza Towers Elementary just collapsed on impact. One teacher described trying to protect her children, how she did it, and the great outcome.
I was on top of 6 kids.
On top of 6 children?
I was lying on top of them.
And they're all okay?
All mine are okay.
Remarkable. By now, you've likely seen many of these images. A huge swath of central Oklahoma has just been flattened into wreckage.
Now you're looking at cell phone video of smashed cars in a parking lot. You can see broken and mangled pieces of metal everywhere. In a few of the parking spots, only the tires were left on some cars. President Barack Obama is calling the storms one of the most destructive in history.
So our prayers are with the people of Oklahoma today. Our gratitude is with the teachers who gave their all to shield their children, with the neighbors, first responders and emergency personnel who raced to help as soon as the tornado passed, and with all of those who, as darkness fell, searched for survivors through the night.
And take a look here from space. Here's the storm system that generated that devastating twister and more. This was taken by a NASA Earth Observing satellite. NASA captured this image just as the tornado touched down yesterday. The devastation in Oklahoma has many asking, what if it happened here? So let's talk to another News 4 meteorologist right now. Chris Justice is right here. And Chris, that big question, is one that strong, an EF5, possible here in the Carolinas and Georgia?
Well, Michael, I've learned to never say never when it comes to Mother Nature, but so far there has never been a tornado of this size here at home. Now, EF5s only account for a little less than 1% of twisters, and when they strike, there's usually nothing left but just some debris and maybe even the concrete foundation of a home. Now, most of our tornadoes are EF1 to at times EF3 strength, and most newly constructed homes are able to withstand that kind of wind in our area. Now, the Insurance Institute for business and homes has a place here in South Carolina where they actually test homes. Now, they've ranked the United States based on scores to how the building codes are. And we in the Carolinas scored upon the top of the country, meaning we have the strictest building codes around next to Florida and up in New Jersey. Now, they are saying that there are certain things that you can do to strengthen your home.
The main thing we ask people to focus on when looking at the vulnerabilities of their house is their roof system. They really need to make sure the roof is tied on by more than just gravity. There are straps that you can buy that are not very expensive, you know, $120 or so, and you can get a really good system tying the roof to the walls.
Now, you're also going to want to look at your garage door. It's your home's first line of defense. If it goes, your roof will soon follow. Look for ways to brace your garage door at your local hardware store. Carol?
Thanks, Chris. 6 years ago, an upstate elementary school was hit by a tornado, and it's a day one man will never forget. Lowell Haynes was the assistant principal at Liberty Elementary back on January 5th, 2007. That is the day an F1 tornado formed and tore a path right through the front of the school. Cars were tossed on top of each other, sending parents who were in the end of the daycare line running for cover. Inside the school, the staff quickly had the students take cover. Thankfully, no one was hurt.
Did not know at that time it was a tornado. Didn't really know until after we'd already done our drill and had the kids in place, and then looked to the parking lot and saw the aftermath of what had happened.
Now, since that tornado, Pickens County Schools have started a new policy that when a tornado watch is issued, all students and portables are moved inside.
We all remember that day, and we know many of you have been looking for ways to help yesterday's tornado victims. So tonight, News 4's Angela Rodriguez with more on the one thing organizations are asking for right now. Angela.
We have checked with the major disaster relief organizations. Right now, volunteers in the upstate are not being deployed. The emergency response vehicles are parked, but that could change in a moment's notice. We know you have seen the images of destruction and devastation, and we know you want to do something to help tonight. So we've checked with the Red Cross. We've checked with the Salvation Army. We've checked with Samaritan's Purse, even local blood banks, and they're all telling us the same thing. What they need right now are financial contributions, and there are three ways that you can do that. Each respective organization, you can go to their website, they each have 800 numbers, or you can text in those donations. Angela Rodriguez, WYFF News 4, Greenville.
All right, Angela, thank you for that. And here's another way for you to reach out to the people of Oklahoma. We're going to help you. Carol and I are going to anchor a live telethon tomorrow here on WYFF4. We call it 4 Tornado Relief. Noon until 7 tomorrow, we're going to give you a chance to help our neighbors out to the west, taking your donations to help the American Red Cross help them. We'll give you the number to call in tomorrow before we begin 4 Tornado Relief right here on WYFF4. And already, we say thank you.